The purpose of this video is to show how ATRO's polyurethane free rotation bushings actually allow a suspension to function the way it was designed to function, and how ATRO's bushing design eliminates stresses created by bushing windup. There are a number of reasons fleets use ATRO bushings. First, there's the material advantage of ATRO's proprietary polyurethane. Not only does it meet or exceed OE specifications, but also it's impervious to the chemicals that bushings are exposed to on a daily basis, including diesel fuel, road wash, and caustic cleaning solvents. Second, ATRO's unique free rotation design allows for significantly easier installation because you can rotate the bolt holes to any position. But the benefits of this design don't stop there. Let's take a brief look at how suspensions are designed to see why ATRO's free rotation feature is so valuable. A suspension operates as a system. An effective suspension design allows incoming forces to dissipate evenly. Walking beams, springs, torque rods, brackets, and other suspension components are designed to handle incoming stresses based on centerline loading. Centerline loading means that the energy travels down the center of these parts. They are engineered to withstand this controlled energy. This is how a suspension is supposed to operate. But with bonded bushings, when new forces misdirect the energy off this intended centerline path, stresses become concentrated in areas not designed to handle it, such as welds, drill holes in brackets, and other relatively weak points. This misdirected force can cause stress fractures, fatigue, and premature failure in these areas. How does this happen? Bushings are intended to act as a point of articulation in the suspension. And though bonded bushings are designed to withstand a fair amount of twisting and shearing, any time they stretch or wind up in one direction, they're fighting to return to a relaxed state, all at the expense of the rubber material squeezed between the inner pin and outer sleeve. The principle here is that any action has an equal and opposite reaction. However much force goes into torquing the bushing, that's how hard it's working to return to a relaxed position. This is why many rods have a bushing angle specified when you buy them. It's why mechanics chalk mark the position of old bushings before they replace it. It's an attempt to minimize the amount of windup in the bushing and facilitate installation. Okay, so what does bushing windup have to do with centerline loading? When you're talking about heavy-duty trucks, certainly there are occurrences that interrupt centerline loading and are unavoidable. But the bonded bushing design can actually create stresses in everyday operation that act to throw loads off the centerline path. Here's a loose analogy. Let's look at someone pitching a baseball. If the pitcher throws a fastball, the baseball travels in a straight line from the mound to the catcher's mitt. This is like centerline loading. The ball, or energy, travels uninfluenced from point A to point B. But if the pitcher snaps his wrist, similar to a bushing windup, he can add a spin to the ball. This spin creates air turbulence around the ball and introduces a force that propels the ball into a curve. This resulting curve is similar to centerline loading veering off course because as the rubber material fights to pull the pin back to a relaxed position, it essentially puts a spin on the energy, causing it to concentrate at points not designed to handle that amount of stress. What other consequences result from bushing windup? One of the most important things to understand about ATRO torque rods is their ability to allow the torque rod bushing to automatically zero out to ride height. While this vital benefit may not be fully understood, its implications are far-reaching. The truck manufacturer sets the ride height for each vehicle at the factory. This is a set measurement and should not change. With an air suspension, for example, the height control valve opens to inflate the airbags when load is added. This compensates for the load automatically and returns the ride height to where it should be. Ride height is the level the suspension, driveline, and U-joints are set to operate at. It is in rebushing the torque rods where bushing windup causes problems. When torque rods are rebushed or replaced, the vehicle is normally lifted on jacks in order to give the mechanic enough room to work. The problem enters in when the jacks are improperly placed on the frame and the axles are allowed to drop. While this opens up the suspension, allowing more space to work on the torque rods, it also stretches it and elongates the ride height. If a torque rod is installed in this new position with fully bonded bushings in each end, the bushing material may be in a relaxed state as long as that vehicle is on the jacks. But the moment the truck is lowered to the ground, the axles reorient to their proper position, and the bushings wind up as the vehicle repositions itself to its proper ride height. This builds a constant stress into the suspension, as the bushings fight to assume a relaxed state. Returning to our baseball analogy, this wind-up introduces a force, like the pitcher snapping his wrist, that puts a spin on the path of the energy as it travels throughout the suspension. It propels the force off the centerline path and prevents the suspension from working correctly and carrying the load and stresses the way it was designed to do. As a result, airbags, shocks, bushings, and brackets, fatigued by misaligned stress, can fail prematurely. ATRO's free rotation design eliminates bushing windup. The vehicle can be lifted on jacks and have the axles dropped. When the vehicle is lowered to the ground, ATRO's torque rod bushings will automatically zero out to correct ride height without stressing other suspension components. The result is a properly functioning suspension that works the way it was intended without premature failures. It's the ATRO difference.